Hey guys, Alita here. I am three on week three as of today for my left hip total hip replacement, and going on 6.5 months for my right hip replacement. A lot of you are want, there's so many questions out there as to what your limitations are and what you can do. First of all, I want to say make sure that you talk to your doctor. And also, if you have not for surgery, you sh your doctor's surgery team should have given you some home care, physical therapy, and occupational therapy for the first 2 weeks, or maybe the first 3 weeks, depending on your ability to take care of yourself. So if that hasn't been done, and you're in maybe a week, you haven't even done the surgery yet. May I just recommend that you ask your surgery team to make sure that the paperwork is done for physical therapy and occupational therapy for the first 3 weeks of in-home care. That's number one. I want to talk to you about five things. So that was number one, is just the administrative work about getting your care. Number two, I want you guys to really understand that this is major surgery, and that you need to be nice to yourself. Be graceful and patient with yourself as you're recovering. Don't try to jump back into the gym. There's a lot of people that are young that are just bouncing back in at week two, which is not really advisable because your body is still trying to recuperate from the major surgery. And so if you have to lay down, lay your butt down and stay down, but in between that, every hour or so, you want to get up and walk. So you make sure you're drinking enough fluids, preferable water. I do half and half. I do half juice and half water because I can't take the taste of cold water all the time. So I'm up about every hour to go to bathroom anyway. So that's a good practice for you to get up and do the 20 steps or so that it takes for you to get to the bathroom, and you're walking. The first week, you are using a walking aid. If you have a walker, make sure you use that. The second week, you might be well enough to be able to transition over to a cane, like I have. I had two canes during the second week, and this is week three. I'm actually walking without the cane, but there's several trigger points inside of your adductors that are really taking the brunt because you're trying to bear weight and it's not liking it. So I would recommend, even during week three, even though you're walking sturdy, slightly sturdy, to still have the cane handy just to take that additional extra weight off your leg. So the first thing I talked about was the admin. Make sure you get the admin work. The second thing I talked about was being graceful to yourself and take the break that you need to take. The third thing I talked about was drink plenty of water so that you're up and down, so that you're walking a lot. When you're laying down, try to put your elevate your feet above your heart. So you, I, for me, I created, I'm going to show you. I created this little monstrosity here. If you can see, it's the patterns from the couch, and so it's higher than the futon, and I just sit in that. So that was what I do. Elevate your feet. The fifth thing is the exercise. I'm going to go over some basic exercises that you can do.